Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. Today I will explain you diaphragm compressor, construction and working animation. I will explain you about Burton Corbolin heavy duty reciprocating diaphragm gas compressors. Howden is a world famed and renowned manufacturer of compressors. Let us see an animation of Burton Corbolin diaphragm compressor. These compressors meet API 618 standards and used for as a process compressors. These diaphragm compressors are hermetically sealed and used for gases like chlorine, hydrogen or various other gases which are used in industries. They provide a leak tight contamination free compressor for all gases. So let us see the internal components of Burton Corbolin heavy duty compressor, their functioning and working principle. In this picture you are looking a mechanical frame. So this is a mechanical frame of this Burton Corbolin compressor. This is a crankcase side, this is a piston side, and these are the diaphragm pack, and in the top plate there are suction discharge valves. So we will see the all internal components one by one and their functioning. So you can see here in the yellow portion the mechanical frame, and this is a diaphragm head. This is a flywheel, so which is rotated by a prime mover with the help of belts. Let us see all the internal components. This is an end cover of crankcase chamber. This is a oil pump, and here you are seeing a oil pressure limiter. This is a lubrication oil pump. This is a compensating pump which control the flow and pressure of the oil along with the diaphragm. Here you can see piston assembly. This one. These are the valve holdings. So these both outside are suction valves, and here, and this valve holding is for discharge valve. Here you can see a inlet check valve in the left side, and in the right side you can see a outlet check valve. This is gas side diaphragm which compress the gases which are to be handled by this compressor. There are other two diaphragms. The intermediate diaphragm is a hydraulic diaphragm, and this is a oil side diaphragm which provide a hydraulic oil pressure to the intermediate diaphragm. The intermediate diaphragm is a hydraulic plate distribute evenly pressure on diaphragm. So this diaphragm assembly consists of three flexible layers of metal discs, one of which is in continual contact with the gas, one with the oil, that drive oscillating between two slotted plate which is intermediate plate, and bottom side is a oil side diaphragm. Here you can see this is a oil pressure limiter which control the flow and pressure of the oil. Here you can see piston and piston rings. So this is a piston and these are the piston rings. Now you can see the assembly of this complete compressor. I will explain you individual parts. Here now you can see the crankcase, crosshead, connecting rod and piston rod. So let us see one by one. This is a crankshaft which is rotating and connected with a flywheel, and flywheel is connected with a motor to rotate the crankshaft. Now you can see while crankshaft is rotating, it is providing a oscillating motion to the connecting rod. So this is a connecting rod. Now let us see crosshead. This is a crosshead which convert this oscillating motion to and fro motion to the piston rod. Now you can see the piston rod is connected with the piston, and this piston will provide oil pressure to the oil diaphragm. So this is providing a oil pressure to the oil diaphragm, and by that gas side diaphragm will be compressed and will compress the gases. So at the top you can see these two. This is suction valve, this is suction valve, and this is a in between. The red color shown is a discharge valve which is discharging the gas to the storage tank or wherever it is required. The compressor is a single acting, single stage compressor. These compressors can provide 15:1 compression ratio in single stage. If we need more higher pressures up to 600 bar, then we need 3 stages. But in a single stage, it can provide up to 250 bar. So you can see the diaphragms are continuously compressing the gas and it is getting discharged. At the top you can see 3 valves. The middle one is a discharge valve and both the side valves are suction valve which suck the gas, and then diaphragm plate compress the gas and discharge through discharge valve. Here you can see the action of diaphragm. These diaphragms are at the end, you can see contact zones where O-rings are provided to prevent leakage of the oil. These are the 3 O-rings which prevent any leakage from this oil from the diaphragm chamber. This is an oil flow through limiter. Here you can see this is a spring loaded oil flow limiter, and this is a oil, excess oil which is returning to the sump. Here you can see the oil is going, and there is a compensation pump which is compensating the oil pressure as per the requirement. Flow and pressure both are compensated by this. This is oil flow from compensator to the head. So this oil is going into the diaphragm head, and here you can see the piston is continuously compressing this oil. So the oil compress the oil side diaphragm, and that finally compress the gases through a gas side diaphragm, and oil is continuously circulating through oil pump. The oil is going and coming back to the sum. So this continuously circulate. So this is overall a diaphragm compressor. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues, subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.